Okay, good morning all of you. Today we will discuss some important competitive information. Later we can move further concept. See, first of all, we are working out on delta G. What is the meaning of delta G? Change in Gibbs free energy. If related problems are given competitive, how we can solve them? Some important concepts is there, I will explain. Under this, first one I am explaining C carefully. If suppose one metal atom is there, it is undergoing oxidation, it is becoming like m plus plus one electron. Anyway, losing of electron is going on, that is calling as oxidation. Then we are getting some delta G value is nothing but that, delta G1 is nothing but x. It is the delta G value for oxidation of the metal. Now if you take reverse, means reduction, means m plus particle will receives one electron, that process or phenomena is calling as a reduction, then it is becoming metal solid form. Okay, it is a reduction, no, oxidation and reduction is quite opposite, that's why delta G2 value is not equals to delta G1, should be coming a minus x. Are you clear? Yesterday we seen already this one. And you can go for further concept, delta G is the extensive property. Delta G is the extensive property. What is the meaning of extensive property in thermodynamics? Yes, it is the property of the system or a process which depends on amount of the matter present in it. Means delta G is the extensive property, means the delta G value depends on amount of the matter. Amount of matter which will be taken in that cell. For example, did you got my point or no? Just you see, M is there undergoing oxidation, it is becoming like M plus plus one electron. For this, delta G1 value is equals to some x, whatever it is, let it be. Okay, but in this oxidation, we are considering how many moles of the metal particle? One metal particle. Now what I am doing, I am taking n number of the metal particles I am taking, means what happening, quantity of the metal will be changing. Definitely what happening, delta G will be also changing. How it is, I will explain. You take m number of metal, n moles of the metal particle is also undergoing oxidation, is becoming like n number of m plus particle and n electrons. Finally, what you did, the whole reaction is multiplied with the one common integer. Definitely delta G will be changing because delta G is the extensive property. How? So then we are getting delta G2 for this. What coefficient we are multiplying? The same coefficient will come as x. Did you got my point? Yes. I will give you one more concept. Delta G is the additive property. Additive property. What is this additive property, you can understand? Just see, if suppose you taken one metal atom undergoing oxidation is becoming like m plus plus one electron. For this, delta G1 is equals to some x. Okay, one more oxidation process is there. It is nothing but m plus is gives rise to m plus 3 gives plus 2 electron. Is it also oxidation? Then we are getting delta G2, is it equal with previous one? No. Why? Because you only one electron lose, some change is there. Here two electron changes there, that's why some compulsory delta G value will be changing. That is delta G2 is equals to y. But questions you will ask. If you take m is gives rise to m plus 3 electron, for this delta G value is how much? Delta G is the additive property. We have to work out already learned in thermodynamics. Okay, I want this equation from these two. How it is possible? Yes, just we have to do addition. Just do it addition. M plus M. So we are getting M plus particle metal ions gives rise to M plus plus 1 electron plus 2 electron is becoming 3 electron and M plus 3 ions. M plus is common, cancel here, we are getting this equation. So this required equation is possible by the addition of the given two equation. Then we can do additive property, means is nothing but delta G is equals to what we can write. Very good, delta G1 plus delta G2, nothing but x plus y is the answer. delta G, while making reverse reaction, the delta G sign will become inverse, plus minus minus plus. And it is the extensive property, means whatever equation is given for the delta G value, something will be there. The whole equation is multiplied with some common number, the same multiplication will be applicable for also delta G. So, and one more thing, it is additive property. He will give two equations, he will ask one more equation delta G value, you have to, he will ask, then you have to understand how you are getting by addition. So, we can do delta G is equals to G1 plus G2. And now, I will work out some explanation on some important concepts related to E. What is the meaning of EMF? Electrode potentials. Electrode potential values. Already we seen one equation. What is that one? For example, N is becoming N plus plus 1 electron. It is oxidation. Then, electrode potential E1 is equals to some X volts VDD. Any problem? No. So, now what I am doing? I am making reverse reaction. N plus plus 1 electron is becoming like M. Is it calling as oxidation? No, reduction. So, then we are getting electrode potential value will be E2 is not equal with E1. Definitely what happening, it's becoming like minus X volts. Already we seen this information under electrode potential. What is the relation between oxidizing potential and reduction potential? Yes sir, electrode potential of oxidation is equals to minus of electrode potential under reduction. This relation already we got it. Same thing for delta G also. Now, I'm telling one more thing, it is E. Means electrode potential, E naught, standard electrode potential, very good, E cell, EMF of this cell, and E naught cell, standard EMF of this cell, all are intensive properties. Intensive properties. What is the meaning of intensive property amount? Intensive, independent on amount of the metal in it. Means all these properties are not depends on amount of the metal present in the cell, amount of metal present in the cell. But delta G is the extensive property, which is I will explain to you. See, for example, M is becoming like M plus plus 1 electron. For this, electrode potential is equals to X volts E1. Now whole equation is multiplying with some common number n. N moles of n is becoming like n moles of the metal ions plus n number of electrons is coming. Is it clear? Means the whole equation will be multiplied with n, means the metal quantity will be changing. Even though any changes in the electrode potential value, no. Why? Because it is the intensive property. Means E2 value is also becoming like X volts only, because it is the intensive property. Did you watch that? This is important. What I am telling you, this model guarantees asking in every competitive examination based on this concept. Okay, electrode potentials is non-additive property. Electrode potentials are non-additive property. What is this meaning? I will explain to you. See. For example, you take a one equation, N is becoming like M plus plus 1 electron. Okay, for this electrode potential is E1, whatever value let it be. Okay, same equation, I am taking one more, M plus is becoming like M plus 3 plus 2 electron. For this electrode potential value, is it same as in previous group? No, it is different equation, that's why electrode potential value will be E2. But I want electrode potential value for this one. M is becoming M plus 3 plus 3 electron. I want electrode potential value for this conversion. Is it possible by adding like delta G? Should not, because it is the non-additive property. Yes, you may get the equation of this required from by adding these two. Possible, yes, you can add it, but should not add electrode potential value, because electrode potential value is the non-additive property. So, how can you solve this one? Should not do direct addition. From E1, we can get that delta G1. Which formula? Yes, very good. Minus of NFE1. And again from E2 we can get delta G2, then we are getting minus NF E2. Okay, what is the N here, sir? Everything will come. N means number of transferred electrons. In the first equation only 1, in second equation only 2, but in third equation only 3. That's why are not equal, that's why should not cancel N value, let it be anyway. For first conversion delta g1, for second conversion delta g2, for this we are getting delta g, we are getting minus nf e, we are getting. Now delta g is the additive property. So what we can take in, delta g is equals to delta g1 plus delta g2. We are getting here n f e minus of n1 f e1 plus n2 f e2 will be coming, because number of electrons should not equal in every case. Here only one electron change, two electron change, here three electron change. By simplification we are getting which value? What we are getting? Electrode potential values we are getting. That's why whenever you given two equations with its electrode potential value, if you want electrode potential value for liquid equation, should not add directly those electrode potential value. First of all, we have to convert them into delta G. Then we have to add those two, because delta G is the additive property. Did you got it? Based on this point only is asking in competitive exams. Did you got it all of you? Yes. Now we are working something regarding some information regarding reduction electrode potentials. Reduction electrode potentials. A very nice concept, Amma. This is also important for competitive examination. We are seeing information related to reduction potentials, electrode potential values. Okay, from this what we can study? Lot of information is there, so much competitive bits is coming here. First of all, we have some information. If reduction potential or electrode potential is denoted by E, E is greater than 0. For any metal, for example, take copper only. For that copper, electrode potential value is how much? Plus 0.34 volts. Like that, for any element, if reduction potential value is greater than 0, meaning is what? We can show this one as E, as greater than 0, means if electrode potential value will be greater than 0, means they are nothing but positive values. Okay, you already studied in Daniel's cell, positive value, negative value. What happened in positive values electrode potential metals? Positive values having reduction potential metals are involving in the oxidation or reduction. These are more favorable for the reduction. More favorable for the reduction means why? Because the reduced form of element is more stable than hydrogen gas. Yes, I will explain by taking some example. First understand. Okay, the electrode potential value may positive values or negative values, but very rare case and only one element is the standard hydrogen electrode, its electrode potential value will be taken as 0, not originally 0, taken as 0. Okay, first case I am telling, for an element, if reduction potential values, that too, reduction electrode potential values is greater than 0 means what? Positive values. The elements which are having positive electrode potential, they are favorable for the reduction. If they are favorable for the reduction, means the reduced form of that element is more stable than the hydrogen gas. What is the meaning of this one? For example, standard electrode potential of copper is plus 0.34 volts. Understand the concept carefully. Standard electrode potential of zinc is minus 0.76 volts. What is the equation? Positive value. Positive value means greater than 0. Greater than 0 means more favorable for the reduction. How Cu plus 2 will receive 2 electrons is becoming like Cu. Okay, relatively this is favorable for the oxidation, let it be. What is the oxidation reaction? Zn is becoming like Zn plus 2 plus 2 electrons. What concept is telling? Okay, this is a more favorable, greater than 0 means more favorable for the reduction. Means which is more favorable? For example, type this one also reduction potential, no? Zn plus 2 is receiving electron is becoming like zinc. It is also reduction. But which reduction is more favorable? Copper is more favorable. Why? Because positive value is greater than 0. And one more point is telling. Reduced form of element is more stable than the hydrogen gas, which is having positive electrode potential. Now, out of zinc and copper, which is stable? compare with hydrogen? Yes, copper is reduced form of, after reduction getting a reduced form of copper is more stable than the hydrogen gas, than the zinc. Why zinc is less, reduced form is less stable? It is having negative constant, that is totally different, let it be. So, whenever the elements are given, the elements which are having positive electrode potential, they are more favorable for the reduction. The reduced form is more stable than the hydrogen gas. Okay, just I will give you one more thing. If suppose electrode potential values means E is less than 0. Less than 0 means what is the meaning of negative electrode potential? Quite opposite to previous concept. Negative electrode potential means what? They are favorable for oxidation. Yes, they are favorable for oxidation. They are favorable for oxidation. Why? The oxidation form is more stable than the hydrogen gas. That's only right. Oxidized form of elements. Oxidized form of elements are more stable than hydrogen gas. More stable than hydrogen gas. I will explain some bits you can understand, and I will give you one example for this one. Standard reduction potential of zinc is -0.76 volts. Yes, you can explain. This is the less than 0 negative value. Negative value means is more favorable for the oxidation than the reduction. So, always zinc is becoming like Zn into Zn plus 2 plus 2 electron. This one is favorable. Okay, later what is telling? This oxidation form is more stable than the hydrogen gas. Means Zn plus 2 is more stable than the hydrogen gas. Is it clear or no?
Yes, sir. Means this zinc is less stable. Zn plus 2 is more stable.
Did you got or no?
Compared with hydrogen, zinc is less stable,
but Zn plus 2 is more stable. Why? Zinc is having negative electrode potential is more favorable for the oxidation.
Okay, just I will give you one more question just for understanding. Electrode potential of copper is plus 0.34 volts, and electrode potential of silver is 0.8 volts. What is the stability order of those pieces? This is 0.34, this is 0.8. Which is more electrode potential? This is the more electrode potential value. More electrode potential value means more favorable for the reduction. Means here Ag plus ions easily receive the electron is becoming like Ag. Here also reduction is going on. Cu plus 2 will receive 2 electrons, is becoming Cu. But which is more favorable?
This one is more favorable.
Now tell me, out of silver and copper, which is more stable in reduced form? Out of copper and silver, which is more stable in reduced form? Which is highest reduction potential value? That will be the reduced form is more stable than the hydrogen gas. Yes, 0.8, 0.3. Yes, silver is more stable than copper, than hydrogen gas.
Both are relatively more stable only, but comparatively, silver is highest stable than copper, than hydrogen. Are you getting or no?
Yes, just I will give you one more point. Okay, in your textbook given, one a table of polymer given, all those values are standard reduction potential values of different metals. If you observe in the table, highest reduction potential value, highest standard reduction potential value having by fluorine. So what is that one? E naught of F2 is 2.87 volts. But what we can explain from this? Among all the periodic table element, highest reduction potential value having by fluorine, that value is 2.87. No other element is more than this value. From this, what we can get? Highest reduction potential value means is favorable for which one? Means the fluorine is ultimate element showing more interest for reduction. Means it is highly reduction tendency. Highly reduction tendency. Okay, if it is highly reduction tendency, means the element is specially calling with one name. The element itself is favorable for the reduction, means the element is calling as? Yes, very good. Highly reduction tendency means it is calling as strongest oxidizing agent. Yes, From this we can tell among all the periodic table element, highest or strongest oxidizing agent is nothing but fluorine. Why? Because fluorine is a highly electronegative element. Highly electronegative element means more tendency to receive the electron. That is only we are calling as reduction. So highly tendency for reduction, it is calling as strongest oxidizing agent. So how it is happening? You know, F2 will receive 2 electron is becoming like 2F minus. This is more favorable because fluorine is ultimate highest electronegative element. Always having a tendency to receive the electron is always has more favorable for the reduction. Itself it is favorable for the reduction, which is calling as a oxidizing. More reduction capacity, more strongest oxidizing agent. All of you getting or no? Yes. We will see some other information. See what you understood? If any element has a positive electrode potential value or greater than 0 electrode potential value, that should be more favorable for the reduction. More favorable for the reduction means the reduced form is more stable than the hydrogen gas. Okay, I given one example for that one. Okay, one more case. If any element having electrode potential value will be less than 0 means negative, it is favorable for the oxidation, then oxidation form is more stable than the hydrogen gas. So highly reduction potential, reduction, cathode, and lower reduction potential, oxidation, or calling as an anode. Now I will tell one more point. Among all the elements, very lowest standard reduction potential value having by lithium alloy. What is the value? What we can understand from this? Standard electrode potential value of lithium is -3.05 volts. So what is the meaning of this one? The least element means it's having very low electrode potential value. Very low electrode potential value means what? Yes sir, it is more favorable for which one? Oxidation. Itself it is more favorable for oxidation means? Yes, more favorable for oxidation means it will be considered as a strongest reducing agent. Why? The released electrode potential more favorable for the oxidation. Itself it is more favorable for the oxidation. It should be calling as strongest reducing agent. Means automatically we can tell lithium is always decomposing like Li plus plus one electron. Reduction is possible but not favorable. What? Based on this whole concept. So which form is more stable? Lithium is stable or Li plus is stable? Compared with hydrogen, Li is stable or Li plus is stable? Li plus is stable. Why? Because this is more favorable for the oxidation. That's why oxidation form is more stable than the hydrogen gas. That's why we can tell Li plus is more stable than the hydrogen gas. But then we can tell Cu plus is more stable, Zn plus 2 is more stable than the hydrogen gas. You can see one more point in case of metals. Yes, very nice concept. In case of metals, reactivity of metals is inversely proportional to standard reduction potential values of the metals. Concept of this one. How can you explain this one? Okay, now reactivity of metals means what is the nature of the metals? Electropositive nature. What is the meaning of electropositive nature? Yes, losing of electrons. Losing of electron means the phenomena is calling as the oxidation. The element which is favorable for the oxidation should have a lower reduction potential or higher reduction potential. The element which is involving in the oxidation means that it will have a high reduction potential or low reduction potential. Low reduction potential means low reduction potential. What I am telling? Reactivity of metal is very high when reduction potential should be low. That's why, what is the relation between them? Reactivity of metal is inversely proportional with the standard reduction potential values. Observe the concept carefully. Don't do by heart the things. So
reactivity of metals we can explain with respect to electropositivity. The electropositivity is nothing but losing of electron, means they are more favorable for the losing of electron. When losing of electron is happening, the phenomena is calling as oxidation. If oxidation is possible, electrode potential value will be low. If electrode potential value will be low, it is a more reactive. That's why in case of metal, reactivity is inversely proportional to standard reduction potential. Just I will give you one question, you can understand. So electrode potential of copper is plus 0.34 volts and electrode potential of silver is plus 0.8 volts. Among these two, what is the most reactive metal? What I told, reactivity is inversely proportional to SRP, standard reduction potential values, in case of metals. Yes, tell me, which is the more reactive? Yes, which one is the lowest electrode potential, that will be more reactive. Then we can tell which one, copper is more reactive than the silver, because out of 0.8 and 0.3, 0.3 is a low. Low means more favorable for the oxidation. That is the nature of the metal, that's why highly reactive. Did you got my point? Can I give one more thing? In case of non-metals, just once you check it out. Reverse. In case of non-metals, reactivity of non-metals is directly proportional to SRP. In case of non-metals, reactivity of non-metals is directly proportional to electrode potential value. Why? Non-metals, what is the nature? Yes, very good amount. Electronegative nature. What is the meaning of electronegative? Yes, very good. Electron gaining tendency. Electron gaining nature. Okay, electron gaining nature is more. Which is more? Reduction is more. Yes, if reduction is more, they are having more reduction potential or low reduction potential? Yes, sir. Highly reduction tendency, no. That means highly reduction potential values. What we are telling? Reactivity of non-metals is high when they are having high reduction potential. Means more reduction potential in case of non-metals, highly reactive. So I mentioned very clearly non-metals and metals. Metals means reverse, but non-metals means directly proportional to its electrode potential value. Did you got my point or no? Now I will explain one thing. Standard electrode potential of fluorine is 2.87 volts. And see, standard electrode potential of fluorine chlorine is 1.36 volts. And standard electrode potential of fluorine chlorine bromine is 1.09 volts. And standard electrode potential of iodine is 0.34 volts. What is the reactivity order? Without this concept also we can tell what the reactivity order of these elements. Fluorine is more than bromine, than chlorine, than iodine. But according to electrochemistry, we have to explain what I told. So reactivity is directly proportional to standard reduction potential in case of non-metal. Yes, sir. Among all these, what are the highest electrode potential value? Fluorine. So fluorine is highly reactive than, next what is coming? Bromine. Next, sorry, chlorine. Next what is coming? Bromine. Next what is coming? Iodine. And sir, why? We can give, according to periodic table also we can give the explanation. Fluorine is a highly electronegative element. Highly electronegative element means highly reduction capacity. Highly reduction capacity, highly reduction potential value. That's why more reactive. If you comparatively, iodine is the less electronegative element. Less electronegative means less tendency for reduction. Less tendency for reduction means electrode potential value will be less. Less electrode potential, less reactivity in case of non-metal. But in case of metals, it is inversely proportional. All of you getting or no? Still is there? So this is the information you have to discuss some other things. Just once you see what is the electric skills, 2-3 points will be there, we will discuss. In case of electrode potential values, so the element which is having positive electrode potential value is always favorable for the reduction. The reduced form is more stable than the hydrogen gas. If any metal has electrode potential value will be less than 0, nothing but negative values. Negative values means they are favorable for the oxidation. Then oxidation form is more stable than the hydrogen gas. In case of metal, so among the periodic table element, highest electrode potential having by fluorine, because highly tendency for reduction.
That's why strongest oxidizing agent among the periodic table element is fluorine. Among the periodic table element, what is the least electrode potential value? Lithium. Just I explained lithium to you. So means what? The lowest electrode potential value.